Potter Box is a model for making ethical decisions, developed by Ralph B. Potter Jr., a professor of ethics at Harvard Divinity School. The box is an ethical framework used to make decisions by utilizing four categories which Potter identifies as universal to all ethical dilemmas. The Potter Box uses four dimensions of moral analysis to help in situations where ethical dilemmas occur: facts, values, principles, and loyalties. First, we start with the facts. This means setting out all the facts without making any judgments or hiding any details. Fact: while excavating at an archaeological site, scientists have discovered ancient human remains. They want to remove them from their ancient burial sites to study their culture and display them in museums. Fact: people who are culturally affiliated with the remains want their traditions to be respected and have the remains to be preserved and returned to their tribe. They want the bodies to remain in their homeland with the belief that this is where they belong. The native belief in spirits and the afterlife requires these sacred bodies to remain where they are. Next, we examine the values. This means stating and comparing the merits of different values as they influence decision-making. Values. The scientists value their knowledge as they want to better understand tribes of previous generations. The tribes value their traditions. Tribal remains are considered sacred and are not meant to be used for scientific study. They also value respect for their ancestors' bodies, meaning that they are not to be disturbed because of archaeological pursuits. Next, we explore the principles. These are the ethical philosophies or methods of reasoning that may apply to the situation. For this section of the Potter Box, we have chosen to use John Stuart Mill's principle of utility. This dictates that we must live our lives so as to create the greatest happiness for the greatest number of people. The scientists want to study the bodies so that they can learn more about the history of the tribes and gain a better understanding of human history. This knowledge can be passed on to others, who want to know more about the people who walk the land before us. The scientists therefore believe that this added knowledge for many outweighs the pain of the few, namely the tribes whose ancestors' remains are being disturbed. This correlates with Mill's ideal of the greatest happiness for the greatest number. Finally, we consider the loyalties of this dilemma. This concerns who the decision-maker has allegiances or loyalties to. First, the archaeologists are loyal to their profession and their pursuit of academic truth. They are obligated to investigate their finds and use them to learn as much as they can about the history of each artifact. At the same time, the natives are loyal to their traditions, cultures, and spiritual beliefs. They are obligated to protect the remains of their ancestors. After using the Potter Box to examine this ethical dilemma, we have decided that the side of the archaeologist is most valid. Although the cultural concerns of the natives must be considered, John Stuart Mill's principle of utility wins in the end. There are only a small number of natives concerned with the protection of the remains, while many, many more could benefit greatly from their scientific study. Because excavating, studying, and displaying the remains results in more good for a greater number of people, the archaeologists should continue with their course of action.
Act crazy, like you just found something awesome.
You don't look dead.
Ow!
No, not that kind of dead. Not like action movie dead. Like long time dead in the ground, dead on the sidewalk. No, you wouldn't be dead with your arms like that. You're not in a casket.
People die.
You look like you just fell off a building.